Welcome to the second part of Lights, Materials, and Render Engines in Thea for Rhino. In this tutorial, we will take a look at some of the material presets. Thea for Rhino provides several ready-to-use materials called material presets. This is a quick way to create and fine-tune common materials, using a simplified material editor which exposes only the necessary properties. Let's start with a plastic preset. The plastic preset has four settings to modify: color, reflection, roughness and bump. The color channel can either have a solid color or a texture map. For this material, we will select a color. Let's apply the material to the objects in the scene and start viewport rendering. To make the material more reflective, increase the reflection value. Now the plastic preset has a zero roughness value. This creates a perfectly glossy material. Change it to something like 10%. And notice how the object surface changes. To introduce irregularities to our material, we can load a texture in the bump channel. Since bump mapping has a very strong effect, it is best if you use small values. Let's continue to our next material. The ceramic preset is basically a material with a glossy finish. It is often used for whiteware, where a glossy finish is required. This preset has two parameters to modify: color and bump. In this example, we have these vases on which we want to apply a ceramic material. Let's create a new Thea material and select the ceramic preset from the drop-down menu and choose a color. We will now apply the material on the objects and start viewport rendering. Now that we can see how the material looks like, we can go on by adding a bump texture, giving our objects a different surface. Press the Add Texture button and select the texture. Decrease the bump value to a smaller percentage to get our final look. This material preset is designed to give a metal appearance with pronounced reflections when roughness is less than 10%. Higher values will result in a rougher and painted metal. We have created a new Thea material and applied it to the scene. Let's start by selecting the colored metal preset. The color value you will select is very important, and you'll have to keep in mind that the brighter the color, the stronger the reflections get. As you can see in this example, we can adjust the color to get the results we're after. To create a chrome metal, select a white color. To make a painted metal, use a different color or use a texture map. We can use the roughness value to control the quality of the surface, from glossy to matte. We can also add a bump map to control the surface's look. That was all about the color metal preset. This type of material can be used to show the finish of timber floors. It has four basic parameters: color, reflection, roughness and bump. Let's choose the laquette type from the drop-down and select the texture map for the color channel. Low roughness values give a polished material look, while higher values make it look more satin. While this material has reflectance by default, you can use the reflection value to make the effect stronger. This is a special preset since it consists of two layers. The first one is a basic layer which has a color that we define, and on top of it a coating layer that is used to simulate varnish and paints over layered materials. The car paint preset is very easy to use since all you have to select is the color and if the paint is metallic or not. Let's select the color, apply the material and start viewport rendering to get a better view. By turning off the metallic option, the coating layer gets disabled and you get a simpler version of the car paint preset. This preset gives a physically based glass that considers refraction inside its volume, in contrast to thin glass. It is used when we want to create physically based glass material where refraction is taken into account. Let's start by applying the thick material preset to our selected object. Now start viewport rendering to see how the material looks like. We can also change the color to any value in order to see our object. You should know that darker values in the color channel create less transparent materials. Increasing the roughness value causes our material to become blurry and get a frosted glass look. And that was all about material presets. In the next tutorial, we will take a look at render engines. Thank you for watching.